Well, next Wednesday will mark the opening of a major milestone for tonight's Newsmaker.
It'll also mean something brand new for downtown Greensboro. The new ice skating rink in Festival Park is the brainchild of someone who has a unique view of life and what a thriving community should be. For Elijah Lovejoy, you could say it's all in the family.
So close to, just look at the buildings around here. You've got, this is a downtown atmosphere.
Elijah Lovejoy is just 31 years old, and his life has already taken many turns. The downtown Greensboro ice rink, which he conceived and will operate once this construction work is complete, is another one.
I'm an ordained minister. I'm actually an Anglican priest here in Greensboro. So I've done that now for 4 or 5 years.
Sure.
But more recently, I've started a business of my own just to be able to have a platform to do things that I've had a desire to do and been daydreaming about, but not really had the freedom to do, I guess, within the church.
His career track isn't that different from his historic great-great-great-great-uncle, who had a similar name.
Talking about Elijah Parrish Lovejoy, who I was named after, my middle name's actually Patrick, because my mom felt like Parrish was a little bit too morbid.
Sure. The Elijah Lovejoy of the early 1800s was also an ordained minister, and like his nephew, generations later, that wasn't his only profession. Elijah Parrish was also a newspaper editor in Illinois who was eventually murdered by a mob for his anti-slavery views.
But the more I've studied him, the more I'm like, he probably had the same questions. Why are you being a newspaper editor? Why are you stirring up all this conflict? And all the way down here to the edge of this.
But while this Elijah isn't stirring up abolitionist views nor violent conflict, he does feel a call to move outside the church and promote what he calls cultural vitality.
If a city doesn't have a sense of cultural vitality, a sense that people care, they're excited, they're wanting to contribute, they're wanting to sacrifice, those sorts of things for the good of the city, then a city just has a hard time thriving.
So in 2009, Lovejoy started an event management company that organized Party on the Plank, an annual downtown summer festival in High Point. But he also felt his company and the community needed a winter activity. He knew of the popularity and success of two new temporary downtown ice rinks nearby, this one in uptown Charlotte and this one in Raleigh. So Lovejoy started taking bids from ice rink companies to build a rink in downtown Greensboro. And one of the companies that bid happened to be the same company set to lay two auxiliary sheets of ice for the U.S. Figure Skating Championships at the Greensboro Coliseum in January.
I actually started talking to them independently.
Did you really?
Of their interest in Greensboro. Didn't even know that there was going to be a figure skating championship in Greensboro.
So you were a step ahead.
A step ahead or step behind or step aside. I don't know what it was, but yeah, I started working on that independently.
Lovejoy then started working with the nonprofit development organization Downtown Greensboro Incorporated.
I receive a performance-based event management fee, but I don't receive any profits above that.
Okay.
So all the money is going to Downtown Greensboro Incorporated. They're receiving all the sponsorship money and they're processing all the event revenues.
Yeah, the refrigeration unit, 150 tons.
The city has agreed to install a transformer that'll not only serve the ice rink, but other Festival Park events throughout the year. The city's also agreed to help cover utility costs, which could run as high as $20,000. The city will also have the option of buying the rink after it closes.
What happens if you get a heat spell?
Well, like I said, Miami, Orlando, Atlanta, they all do this.
But in other words, you can still ice skate when it's 70 degrees outside.
You can ice skate when it's 70 degrees outside.
How confident are you that there are going to be enough people interested in ice skating to support this project?
Greensboro is a big college town. It's a big kids and families town, which tend to be some of your prime, prime ice skaters. Greensboro has just as good a shot as any other city in North Carolina of pulling this off.
Something that would probably make old Uncle Elijah proud.
Lovejoy says the rink should be up and running next winter, whether the city decides to spend the $65,000 to buy it or not. It's also temporary, meaning grass will regrow on the spot after crews remove it. For information on the rink, skate rental hours, and other events associated with it, just take the link to the website from ours at myfox8.com. wghp.com. Again, scheduled to open next Wednesday. Either of you ice skate?
I'm practicing my triple toe loop.
Oh my.
Triple
that would be a sight to behold. Have you ever tried ice skating?
I would now. That would be a fun date
night.
Right.
You know, it's okay
if you're just slipping and sliding.
I've tried it.
I'm gonna
need one of those walker things that you have to kick out the ice with.
I'd like to see that.
Yeah, it's a sight to behold.
Hey, with this North Carolina football thing, it's like Rosanna Dana used to say, it's always something. Yes, it keeps going. Today's news from